Right outside of Fairbanks, Alaska, is a massive wetlands complex known as Minto Flats. I was invited here by my friend Brant Meixel, who is a waterfowl biologist currently working this region on a study of avian influenza.
So now before we start plucking, you need to do some testing on these birds?
Yep, we're gonna sample all of them for avian influenza.
Everything that we sample first is screened for H5N1.
For the last 5 years, we've been sampling these birds from early spring when they get here in May, every single day catching wild birds through the fall. When it gets into hunting season, September, we've been doing bag checks. So we keep that string going of data. We sample for H5N1, then we ask other questions, fitness effects, infection rates, duration of infection, that sort of thing.
Avian influenza, that same thing you hear like on the news, bird flu.
Yeah, it's bird flu, but you hear about the H5N1, the Asian bird flu that's killing people, killing birds.
What we're really researching here is what we call low pathogenic avian influenza, as opposed to high pathogenic avian influenza, which is the Asian H5N1. This is, relatively harmless. At least there's no really observable direct fitness effects.
Is there a reason to think that birds here there's a higher infection rate here than somewhere else?
We know at Minto Flats there's high occurrences of avian influenza. Seems to be fewer infections early. It really builds. You get into August, September, a lot of birds infected.
How many would you say in your years have you tested so far?
You know, we've taken 5,000-6,000 samples a year for the last 4 years.
Is that right? So you've handled that many ducks.
Yep, we sample multiple times, and that's where we got a couple banded birds today, and that's where that really comes in to play.
So now you'd be able to take this bird and see if he had it before, maybe he's got it now.
Yep, you'll find out the date it was banded, how old it was, and who banded it and where it was banded. It's part of a long-term research project here, so we're gonna sample these birds, get some opportunistic data, while we're here, while we have
opportunistic meaning like we just got some birds, might as well sample them.
Exactly.
Yeah, I got you.
Might as well. Biologist always has a pencil in his waders. So we got Steve's band here. First thing we're going to do is record that band number. 1927-62605. And what's the species on that?
Mallard.
I need the scientific name.
Do not know.
Anis platyrhynchus. All right, sex?
Male.
How do you know it's a male by the wing?
Because these white deals would overshoot and go quite a ways this way.
We're gonna test for an upper respiratory infection. So we're gonna hold that bill open. We wanna get into the back of the throat, the trachea, and up on the top of the bill, and the sides of the back of the tongue. So just nice and gently, we're just trying to get those skin cells and those virus cells off there. Now we're gonna put this on ice, freeze it at minus 80 Celsius, really cold, and that'll preserve that virus.
All right, so it's gonna take you another, 15 minutes?
Yeah.
Or while you finish testing, I'm gonna start plucking a couple dinner ducks.
Looks good, looks delicious, man, make my mouth water.